Right, Aki Karimi for Boxing Now, formerly known as BBTV. And I'm delighted this morning to be joined by Matthew Hatton. Matthew, great to speak to you, mate. We're a few days on from the fight, obviously Campbell and Jimmy Joe Flint for a Central Area title. Campbell's first professional loss in a really good fight, though, which we'll touch on. First thing first, mate, how are you? How's Ricky, Campbell? How's the reaction been now the dust has settled?
Mate, we're all absolutely devastated. I think it was something we didn't see coming. We was confident going into that fight. We're winners, mate. We like to win. We hate losing. So everybody's gutted.
Yeah, I mean, of course, it had a good build-up. It did get a little bit interesting in the build-up because it started off respectfully. Then, obviously, it got a bit fiery, which, you know, there's nothing wrong with that. But on the night, the lads delivered. They did deliver in the fight. But we'll get to that in a second, the actual fight. But how's Campbell? I know you said he's gutted, but have you had a bit more of an in-depth chat with him since the fight? And how's he holding up?
Yeah, he was devastated. He was devastated after the fight. I've spoken to him again since, you know, been touching base with him. And he's back in the gym now, back training, which always makes you a little bit more positive. He's obviously, you know, the fight was only on Saturday, so he's still disappointed. But, you know, he's got to look at the fight, watch the fight, dust himself down and bounce back.
Yeah, loads of stuff to discuss here. I actually was at the fight, I saw it there from ringside. I've tried to watch it back on TV this morning, but they've not put the full fight back yet. Have you guys managed to get the footage? Have you actually seen the full fight back yet?
Yeah, I actually watched the fight back on Sunday, the day after the fight. I didn't really agree with the scorecards. I do think they got the right winner, but the scorecards were quite wide, and I really didn't see that. And then I watched the fight again the day after. And although I feel he got the right winner, it was a close, close fight. So I have watched the fight. It was a brilliant fight. Fair play to both guys. Great effort. And Campbell will be... I think what cost Campbell was the experience. Mm. It was purely the experience that cost him. And having done the 10 rounds now... it will only stand him in good stead moving forward.
You mentioned the scorecards. The scorecards, I've got them here actually in front of me. So we've got 98 to 92. We've got 97 to 94. We've got 97 to 95. So yeah, that the John Latham scorecard there, 97 to 95, is kind of around how I saw it, to be honest. But the other two are quite wide. So how did you actually score it? How did you score it?
I thought it was very, very close. I thought they got the right winner. But I had Campbell going into the later rounds. I had Campbell ahead, and Jimmy Joe did what he does. He always finishes strong, which is a testament to him. And he had a really strong finish winning the last three rounds, which won in the fight, in my opinion. But up to round seven, I had Campbell ahead, and... to give Campbell just two rounds in that effort, I really didn't see that.
It's one of those fights, isn't it, where the scorecard doesn't reflect the actual fight. I mean, it was... I was there, obviously, and at the end of the fight, there was a standing ovation from pretty much everyone around the ring, which does stand, does show a lot there, because going into this fight, Campbell had a lot of criticism. I think at the end of this fight, as we'll discuss in a second, that the public perception has changed slightly. But let's just talk about the actual fight. So Campbell gets out the gates, and it's a good start from him. Where do you feel like he started to lose the momentum? You mentioned down the stretch there, but what do you think sort of changed the momentum from Jimmy Joe's side?
Yeah, I thought that Campbell had a good start to the fight. Maybe put a little bit too much into the early rounds. I think Jimmy Joe was landing the better shots. But I think Campbell had the better part of the... just one sec, mate. Let me just let the dog out.
I might keep this in just for a bit of suspense in the interview.
Mate, he's scratching at the door. He's doing me head in.
See, this is real. This is real interviewing people. Real interviewing. Anything can happen at any time. So, yeah, so he got off to a good start. Yeah.
Yeah, I thought Campbell got off to a very, very good start. I then thought the middle rounds was nip and tuck. Jimmy Joe was landing some really good shots. He put a big emphasis on the body attack to Campbell. Again, we sort of like touched on this in the build-up to the fight. We said that Jimmy Joe would target Campbell's body. We knew that, and he did. And Jimmy Joe had a really, really good finish. But it was a cracking contest, close fight, but the right winner.
Cracking contest, it really was. I mean, it was fight of the night. I always thought it would be, to be fair, and it did. It delivered in that term. I think both Campbell and Jimmy Joe showed how determined they were to take that central area title home, didn't they, as well? So a lot of credit can be said. I mean, did you know, when you watched it back, obviously taking the fact that your family and your Campbell's trainer out of it, you know, did you just enjoy the spectacle? Did you enjoy the dust-up? Because it was a dust-up, wasn't it?
It was a proper fight. Did I enjoy it? No. Being Campbell's coach and uncle, it was a tough, hard, grueling fight. But, you know, like you said, the feedback's been very good, actually. It's mad because we sort of like, Campbell's very determined. He's got lots of heart. There's absolutely no quitting him. But, you know Campbell well, I know him well, we all know it. We knew that. And these people that sort of like think he's got it easy, he's got it tougher, he's got it harder than anybody, really. Jimmy Joe's, that fight is the perfect example for that because, you know, you watch Jimmy Joe's fights on YouTube and he's a good, good fighter. He'd never shown anywhere near that level of a performance, in my opinion. And that's a testament to him, how he was able to raise it and improve his game and lift his game on such a big occasion. But that just highlights how tough Campbell's got it.
I think Campbell ticks a lot of boxes there, didn't he? I like you say, we know what Campbell's made of, but he definitely ticked the box with people in the chin, the heart, that type of thing. And he got a lot of respect afterwards. I did see like a sway of the sort of opinion afterwards. It's a bit weird boxing, isn't it? Like you come out of a defeat and you get more respect. But, you know, in a sense, if you're going to lose, you want to lose in a good fight against another good kid, giving it everything and then getting the respect of the people afterwards, don't you?
100%. And it's funny, you know, people that have been very critical of Campbell in the past, being a lot more complimentary. I think people are the realisation is starting to creep in now, exactly how tough he's got it and how much he wants it. You know, he showed tremendous heart and determination and balls in that fight. And hopefully people will start getting behind him.
Now, on Jimmy Joe's side, he's obviously fought his way into a position now where he deserves to move on, realistically. You know, it was a good fight and he deserves to move on. But the fight was so good that, you know, you wouldn't mind seeing that one again. I mean, would you want to see that maybe down the line again, that fight, for even maybe if they get in the positions one day fight for a British title or something? Or do you feel like this is a level where Campbell needs to get that central area belt if Jimmy Joe moves on to sort of tick that box on the journey?
Yeah, you know, if Campbell is going to get to the levels where he wants to get to and we want him to get to, you know, Eddie Hearn spoke after the fight and said, you know, give Campbell one more fight and then do it again. And I think that's the right way to go. I think that's the right route to take because, you know, that's a fight, you know, it's an area title fight. And that's a fight that Campbell has to win to go on where we want him to get to. And no doubt he wants to get to their fights. He has to win. So I think Eddie Hearn's on the right lines there. Maybe one more fight and then run it back. I know the fans would certainly want to see it. And now having done the 10 rounds and got that knowledge and experience behind him, I'd give Campbell a good chance going into another fight with Jimmy Joe. And realistically, I know I'm repeating myself now, if Campbell wants to go to where he wants to go to and we want him to go to, it's a fight he's got to win.
Well, we'll wait to hear about the developments on that particular episode there. Obviously, after a defeat, and it's his first professional defeat, there's always unpacking and like dismant sort of like unpacking and like analyzing, let's say, not dismantling, but analyzing a fight afterwards. You know, sometimes, you know, there's hard conversations that have to be had about the fight and what went wrong and etc. You've mentioned experience there, but do you feel that there was anything else that you would, you know, looking back on it, that you could have done differently, that you would have done differently in the fight?
Yeah, these are all things, you know, these things that we've worked on, you know, in the build up to the fight that Campbell wasn't able to implement on the night. And there's always stuff you can work on. There's always stuff you can do better. And hopefully he'll be able to do that next time with the experience behind him.
So I guess the question, I know it's just like Thursday of you know, we've only just had the fight, but I guess, you know, you've mentioned the Campbell's already back in the gym. So have you guys got a plan for this next fight? Is you know, the next two fights you mentioned, perhaps Jimmy Joe might be on the radar again, a couple of fights. But have you guys talked about this? Is there a plan to be sat down with Campbell, with Eddie Hearn, to really map out what that next fight will be in terms of levels?
Yeah, not too sure, really. You know, it is still quite soon, but there's no point in sitting around. You know, Campbell's got to plan his route forward now and the right direction to move forward. Eddie Hearn said about getting in one fight and then taking on Jimmy Joe again. And I think that's the right direction to go in. Campbell's got to look at the fight, assess the fight, assess the build-up and everything going into it. And, you know, he's got to find a way to improve his skills and to push on and move forward. And that's what he should be spending. You know, he's got a bit of time now. It was a tough physical fight. You know, you've got to give that body time to heal. But now's the perfect time for him to think about things he did wrong in the fight, things he could do better, things he can do better next time, because it is looking like the fight is going to happen again. So he's got to think the right route forward for him now, the right way to go, you know, find a way to make it happen for himself.
And you know, as a coach and a fighter relationship, and obviously you're his uncle as well, have you sat down and just sort of had a conversation about the fallout of the fight together and you know, what happens next and things like that?
Yeah, I mean, me and Campbell's always been so close, really. You know, both myself and Ricky was always a little bit reluctant to push too far with Campbell. But I remember we was only young and he was, you know, probably 15, 16, and he was fighting in the amateurs and, you know, win one, lose one. And you know what? I thought, he's capable of more, he can improve, he can get better. So I'm going to offer to help him. So at that stage, I thought, you know what? I'm just going to offer to help him, give him as much or as little as my time as he wants. So I started working with him. Ricky then started working with him also. And again, we just got more and more involved. You know, Ricky's always, you know, busy and stuff like that, but I made Campbell a priority. I was coaching him a lot of the time, and then I've been training him, you know, ever since. So then when he turned professional, it was me that let me just feed the dog.
Just getting to a good bit there, weren't we?
He's oh mate, he's whinging and whining behind.
No worries,
me.
It's all good.
Mate, let me just get him some food. Cool, mate. Yeah, so, you know, I offered to give him as much time or as little time as he wanted. So I started working with him, coaching him most days, and he got better and he improved. So I've been working with him for about 7 years now, and he's been getting better and improving. And I've really enjoyed it. It's been fantastic. You know, I love Campbell. We got him great. I've always done a lot for him. I've always made him a priority. He's got off to a good start. But I think now we've spoken since the fight, and I think it's time. I've trained him for 7 years now. I think it's probably time now for him to, you know, probably move on. Maybe look at a different gym, new trainer, new environment. I know it helped me in my career when I moved from Billy Graham's gym. I went with Lee Baird, and just, you know, new ideas, new environment, was able for me to improve. And hopefully that can be the case for Campbell. You know, we sat down and we discussed it. We've worked really well together over the last 7 years. But, you know, I think that was a little bit of an eye-opener. And, you know, I think it's time for a change. I think you need to look at a new trainer, new ideas, new training methods, and hopefully he can get better and improve, which he needs to do.
Well, it's kind of like bittersweet, I suppose, because it's quite sad to be talking about that, like the end of an era, especially when it's family as well. But I'm sure you guys, I'm assuming this is a very fresh conversation, but I mean, I'm assuming you guys are parting on good terms, because I'm not, like you said, you're very, very close, and you know, you always have been. But is there a bit of sadness there as well, because it's like the end of an era?
No, more sadness of the way I wanted Campbell to. It would have been nice if it would have ended on a better note. I always said at the very start when I got involved with Campbell, like you say, me and Campbell get on great. We really do. I always said to him, we'd never, ever fall out about boxing because, you know, it means too much to me. And I've done a hell of a lot for Campbell. I've always made him a priority. I've really enjoyed it. It's been great. Like I say, I've just been to his house and we just had a chat. We had a cup of tea. And we're all on the same hymn sheet. You know, we all want what's best for Campbell. And I just think it's an obvious time for him to move on. You know, I've given him some advice this morning. I said, you know, go round, try different gyms, which I did myself. You know, you might have in your head some person that you want to work with, but you could click with somebody else. So it's a big decision. So, I've spoke to him this morning. And the advice I've given is go and try a few different gyms, speak to different people, make the right decision, and do everything you possibly can to make it happen for yourself. But take your time, go and visit a few different gyms and try and find a fit that you think that's going to work best for you. And, you know, I just go back now. I've spoke to him, you know, I'm always at the end of the phone. He might even still want to use I'm there for Campbell to do whatever, whenever he wants it. I'm always there to advise him, which I always have done, and that will never change. I can just go back to being his number one supporter, as I always have been, and his uncle now. So, yeah, you know, it's 7 years. Am I sad about it? No, I've enjoyed it. And like I always say, the future's his. You know, he's got to do the right thing by himself and find a way to make it happen. So I think his change is right for everyone. And I'll be the first person getting a ticket off him down there with a gangmate, shouting him on from the crowd now.
Well, I hope you're going to get a discount on the tickets, but...
So do I.
Yeah, have you suggested any gyms, or are you letting him do that completely on his own?
Do you know what, mate? I honestly think I've sort of like, from when he was 15, 16 and he was struggling, I've sort of like took a pivotal role really and advised him and stuff like that. Campbell's a clever lad anyway. I've told him if he wants my advice, all he has to do is ask. No, Campbell's a clever lad. Like I say, he's got to visit different gyms. That's what I did. You know, went around looking at different gyms and try and find a fit that works for him. I'm always there for Campbell. I love him to bits. I always have been there for him. I've always made him a priority, and I always will.
I guess, I suppose, because it's come out of a bit of the blue, caught me by surprise a little bit, that has. But do what's next for yourself then, Matt? Because obviously, you've just started doing your amateur shows there with the gym. I'm not aware of any active pros currently that you train. So what's next for you? Are you looking to get some more pro fighters on, or what's the situation there?
Yeah, I don't know what's round the corner for me. I'm really busy, as you know, Aki. You've been down to my gym. It's a busy, thriving gym. I do all sorts. We've got the amateurs there now, which I really enjoy helping out. When the amateurs joined, I thought I'd sort of like be a bit part player, but I just love being involved with it. And I love giving back. I love helping. We do different projects at the gym. You know, with kids and getting, you know, in antisocial behavior, the gym's buzzing. We do classes, courses, all geared around the boxing. So I'll just concentrate on that for the time being. I've got Jack, of course, and what have you. Spend a lot of time coaching him. So it is good, all geared around the boxing. So at the minute, I'll just concentrate on running my gym, and just see what the future holds. It'll certainly it'll I've always, it's always been boxing for me. I love me boxing. I got into the sport originally because I was a big boxing fan. Done it for many years, and I'll be involved in many years. So on the professional side, who knows? Who knows what's around the corner? But yeah, it's on the shelf for the minute.
Fair enough. And well, you've got your son Jack, as you mentioned there, coming through, doing great in the amateurs. He's getting bigger and bigger. I was actually sat with your mum on at the fight on fight night just before the fight. We were chatting, and she was saying about how it's not that just after Campbell's generation, there's a whole new generation coming through from the Hatton family. So, you know, I suppose you're going to be investing time, especially when Jack gets into that sort of the class where he's starting to get really real tussles on and everything like that. So is that something you're looking forward to as well, that sort of rejuvenation and starting a new generation?
Yeah, you know, it's early days for Jack. You know, he's only been boxing 2 years, but how far he's got, he's one of the best kids in the country already in just 2 years of boxing, 29 fights. He's doing tremendous. But, you know, just take it one day at a time. I'm in no rush with Jack. You know, I'm working with Jack and working with some of the other amateurs. I enjoy all the stuff that I do at the gym, really. So who knows what the future holds, but boxing will always be a huge part of it for me.
What one last one then, Matt? Obviously, after the fight on Saturday, everyone likes to have an opinion and have their say, and everyone's debating this and debating that. A couple of comments about where's Campbell's level going to be after this fight? Do you feel like he can get to where he wants to be and raise it? Do you feel like this change of potential changing trainers can see him raise his levels and get to the next stage that he wants to be at?
Yeah, you know what? Campbell's going to be a better fighter from that experience. Going the 10 rounds with a good fighter, he's a young man. He's going to mature. He's going to develop. He's going to again expand his boxing education. You know, he spent time in America training over there. So it's undoubted that Campbell will improve and will get better. Like you say, he's just lost the fight there at the weekend. Rematch looks on the cards, but Campbell will want to go higher than area title level. You know, Campbell will want to fight for major titles, and I believe he can. He's got to keep working hard, keep improving, and find a way. You know, it's in his own hands. Make the right decisions and find a way to make it happen for yourself. You know, many fighters, including myself, have done it over the years, had early setbacks and come back stronger. And that's what he's got to do now. I really hope he can.
Fair enough, mate. Well, it wouldn't be any interview with you if we didn't do end on an Ask Matt. We've got a fight this weekend coming up. Wardley Clark is the main event. I don't know if it's one you're watching. I'm assuming you will do, but any pre who do you think is going to win? Any sort of preference? Have you looked into it much?
Yeah, do you know what? It's a great fight. And again, people have sort of like spoken about this fight for a while now. And I've always fancied Fraser Clark quite strongly. If you'd have asked me 12 months ago, I'd have said Fraser Clark without a doubt. But, you know, Wardy's looked so good recently, hasn't he? Over the last couple of fights, again, coming from a white collar background. And it's amazing how quickly he's improving. Fraser hasn't looked quite so good in his last couple of fights as he stepped up a little bit. So it's a real pick and fight for me. 12 months ago, I'd have fancied Fraser Clark all day long. Again, mate, I don't sit on the fence. If you push me now, I'd probably fancy Wardley.
All right. Well, yeah, you know, I know you don't sit on the fence. That's why I always ask you. Because I know you're gonna...
You always get an answer, mate. You always get an answer. Mate. I'm not always right, but
you're going for Wardley, and quite a lot of people have asked. There are some that are picking Clark, obviously. But do you find that a bit quite an interesting? Because obviously, like you say, you come from white collar, whereas Fraser's got the depth of the amateur experience. He's been away all over the world fighting, and he's the bronze medalist from the Olympics. But a lot of people going Wardley. So has that got good signs for future fighters who don't necessarily come from the amateur system? Because a lot of people don't realize is you do actually need to have some money in your pocket if you're going to be going around the world fighting as an amateur.
Like you say, and I'm a firm believer in the amateurs, mate. I think that's the right way to go. I think fighters who have got the amateur pedigree generally do better. Not always, of course, and this is the perfect example for that. But, you know, there's some fighters that have come from the unlicensed white collar and done very well. But Fabio's rise has been tremendous, really, hasn't it? So even though Fraser's got the pedigree and the amateur grounding behind him, it is an eye-opener, really, that guys that necessarily haven't had the amateur pedigree can still go on and do it. So it's good to see, actually, and very, very interesting. It's an interesting fight for those reasons you've just touched on.
You've gone for Wardley. It's a heavyweight fight. Are you going inside the distance or are you going points?
Yeah, I think for Wardley to win, he'd be doing very, very well to outbox Fraser, you know, for the 12 rounds. And KOs is what he does, isn't it? So, yeah, I'd probably go for a Wardley KO. I wouldn't have thought it would be early. I would have thought it'd probably be later in the fight, but it's going to be a hell of a fight.
It's going to be a great fight. Yeah, looking forward to that one. And Matt, thanks as always for your time. I mean, bittersweet in a way, because I didn't expect what you'd said about parting ways with Campbell, but, you know, everything's for a reason, and I'm sure it's all the best interests for you guys have had that conversation. But yeah, mate, we're still going to do our Ask Matts though, right? They're not going to stop, right?
Oh, mate, anytime. And like you say, it's you know, I'll see you at the shows. And like I say, I'll go back to being Campbell's number one supporter and uncle now. But, oh, mate, always phone me up for an Ask Matt anytime, you know that.
Definitely. And I will do. And all the best to you and Campbell and the whole family. And I'll look forward to chatting with you again soon, mate.
Top man. Let's see how you do under pressure. Oh.